So hey, what's up mga kote? It's me, Ate Mariel, at welcome sa Kodoy News, where learning is the name of the game. So kung bago ka pa lamang sa aming YouTube channel, i-click mo na subscribe, like, and share button para mag-i-updated ka sa aming mga videos. So samahan natin si Super K sa panibagong araw at panibagong lesson na ating matututunan dito sa Kodoy News. At ang bagong lesson natin for today is plants for medicinal purposes. So yan, ang goal natin for today is malaman natin yung mga plants na pwede tayong matulungan for our health. So disclaimer lang po, so never attempt self-medication, so never use herbals without your physician's approval. So yan. So number 8, plants are used for medicinal purposes. So itong number 8 na to ay konektado sa plants for people. And hiniwalay ko siya dahil interesting to na malaman na yung iba't ibang mga plants pala ay pwede siyang maging beneficial for us when it comes to our health, and pwede siyang maging medicine. So, although people are now turning to herbal medicine, care must be taken when using them. Herbs are not subject to the same government scrutiny as pharmaceutical drugs. So, yan. So, number ito, disclaimer lang, the following precaution must be considered. So, disclaimer lang, and of course, warning sa inyo pag gumagamit kayo or gusto nyo mag-take ng herbal plants. So, number one, never attempt self-medication for serious illness. Of course, kapag meron kayong mga serious illness, you must see or must consult your doctor para magbigyan kayo ng gamot. And itanong nyo muna kung pwede yung mga herbal plants sa inyong gustong gamitin para makapagpagaling sa inyong mga sakit or makatulong for your healing. So, letter B, never use herbals without your physician's approval. So, always consult your physician if you want to take a herbal medicine. So, ask them if pwede siya sa katawan nyo, if paano yung gagawin nyo, if ano yung magiging side effects if you will use a herbal medicine. So, letter C, monitor its effects on you. So, monitor it if may mga side effects ba, ano ba yung nangyari after you use it, after you drink it, or after you use your herbal medicine. Discontinue use if allergic reactions appear. If there are allergic reactions, if there are another side effects na nagmulas or nanggaling sa inyo, so stop the herbal medication or taking herbal medicine. So, it's better to consult your doctor to have a better medication for your illness. So, letter D, take the recommended dosage at suggested intervals. So, if you yung parang nagsamangguni kasi yung mga physician, take the dosage yung binigay sa inyo. If 3 times a day, so 3 times a day lang, walang kulang, walang sobra. So, ganon. If 1 times a day lang, isang beses lang sa isang araw ka dapat iinom or kakain ng ganyan, so yun lang dapat yung sundin. So, always rely and ask your physician if it's safe or not. So, yan ang ating mga precautions before we study about some medicinal plants. So, maraming medicinal plants na pwede makita sa ating kapaligiran. But this, yung mababanggitin ko ay ilan lamang sa mga medicinal plants na maaaring yung makita sa bakuran, sa market, or sa mga likod bahay ninyo. So, number one is aloe vera or sabila. So, parts use, or yung pag sinabi natin part use, ito yung mga pwede natin gamitin for herbal, for your herbal medicine intake. So, ang uses niya, or yung parts used for aloe vera is juice from leaves. So, yung juice niya ay nasa loob. So, when you see an aloe vera, it looks like para siyang may spine. So, pag binuksan niyo, so may juice na lalabas from its leaves. So, yun ang pwede natin gamitin. So, ang uses niya, heal wounds, burns, eczema, antibacterial, antifungal, and reduces inflammation. So, many of the beauty products uses aloe vera for our skincare routine. And marami talaga mga products na meron talagang content na aloe vera for our skincare, and of course, for many para sa ating katawan. So, marami talagang uses yung aloe vera. So, yan yung mga uses niya. heal wounds, burns, eczema, antibacterial, antifungal, and reduces inflammation. So, sa preparation niya naman, kung paano siya magagawin, so, extract juice from leaves. So, you will extract the juice from the leaves of aloe vera. So, sa number 2 natin, bitter gourd or yung ampalaya. So, leaves and fruit niya. So, from its bitter gourd, ano natin mapait yan. And ito, uses niya is for diabetes, regulates fertility, and for hemorrhoids. So, yan yung kanyang use and yung benefits na makukuha natin sa ampalaya. So, preparation natin, eat as vegetable or tea capsule. Powder the leaves and use as astringent. So, meron talaga may mga gamot na ganyan, yung may mga ampalaya content. So, before you take a medicine or yung mga capsule, you must also see a doctor if okay yun sa inyo and ano yung magiging dosage na pwede nyong ma-intake for every day. So, yan. So, capsicum. So, yun yung siling labuyo. So, yung fruit na nang gagamitin natin. So, yung uses niya is anti-spasmodic, relieves pain, toothache, backache, and rheumatism. So, yan. Macerate in vegetable oil for 1 to 3 weeks. Apply oil on painful areas. So, i-apply mo yung magiging yung para magiging product mo na nilagay mo yung olive oil and yung capsicum, ma-macerate mo in olive oil for 1 to 3 weeks. So, yung magiging result nun, pwede mo siyang i-apply for your painful areas. If nagkaroon ka ng allergic reaction, so you must stop it. Okay? So, celery or kinchai. So, madalas pwede ito makita sa ingredient for pancit. So, mga pancit sa ating mga handaan. So, yan, fruits, leaves, and stems. So, relieves gout, arthritis, and rheumatism. So, yan, crush, yung ano niya, preparation niya is crush seeds in boiling water and drink. Pwede mo siyang inumin. So, yan. So, number 5 na tayo. So, meron tayong 6 tayo dito. So, yung garlic natin or yung bawang. So, cloves niya. For high blood pressure and high cholesterol. So, pwede mo siyang i-eat ng raw. So, pag nakita ka ng bawang, you can eat it directly na. So, of course, if you want, you can wash it muna. Kasi, you must clean your hands before you eat it. So, mint leaves or herba buena. So, yung leaves nung kailangan natin and ang uses niya is expectorant, relieves toothache, headache, and insect bites. So, yung preparation niya is crush leaves and use poultice mouthwash for toothache. So, yan yung ating mga herbal medicines or plants that can be used for medicinal purposes. So, aloe vera, bitter gourd, capsicum, celery, garlic, and mint leaves. So, yan. For your memory bank, plants provide people with many benefits. Practically, all parts of many plants can be used as food. So, plants also provide materials for making many useful things. Medicinal plants should be used with caution. Herbals should never be used without physician's approval. And plants can also cause harm. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. Click the thumbs up button if you like this video and leave a comment down below if you have suggestions, clarifications, and suggestion regarding to our recent and for our future videos. So, you can email us at quadernos@gmail.com. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless and see you in my next video. Bye-bye!